Amen.
You desire to be united to the Holy Orthodox Church of Christ.
I desire it from my heart.
You believe in one God, glorified and worshipped, in the Holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and do you worship Him as King and as God?
I believe in one God, worship, glorified, and Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and I worship Him as King and as God.
You need the frustration. That's the creed.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible. And in one Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God, the only begotten, begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not made, of one essence with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate under the Spirit of the Virgin Mary, and became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate, and suffered, and was buried. And the third day he rose again, according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge the living and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, proceeds from the Father, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets. One holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Blessed is God who enlightens everyone who comes into the world. Enter into the Church of God and cast aside every error and false doctrine, and honor the Lord God, the Father Almighty, Jesus Christ, His Son, and the Holy Spirit, the one living and true God, the Holy Trinity, one in essence and undivided. May God be gracious unto us and bless us, and make His face to shine upon us like the rain being on the earth, to save the power of all the nations. Let the peoples praise you, O God, let all the peoples praise you. Let the nations be glad and sing for joy. For you judge the peoples with equity, and guide the nations upon earth. Let the peoples praise you, O God.
Send your Spirit that they should be created to renew the face of the earth. Turn, O Lord, how long have we treated for your servants? Let the crooked be made straight, and the rough places level. Save your servants, O Lord, my God, who have hope in you. Lead to them, O Lord, full of strength in the face of the enemy. Let not the enemy prevail against them, nor let the son of iniquity go about to do them evil. O Lord, hear my prayer, let my cry come before you. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. spiritual child, who has confessed to my lowliness. It's not I who have the power to forgive sins upon earth, but God alone. But through the divine voice which spoke to the apostles after the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, saying, if you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained. Taking confidence from this, we also say, whatever you have confessed to my lowliness, whatever you do not mention, whether from ignorance or forgetfulness, may God forgive you both in the present age and in the age to come. O God, who forgave David the sins which he confessed through the prophet Nathan, and Peter that did not be bitterly wept over, and the sinful woman who wept at your feet, and the publican and the prodigal son, may the same God forgive you all for me, the sinner, in this age and in that to come, and may he present you blameless before his fearful judgment seat. Therefore, take no thought for the sins which have been forgiven you, but go in peace.
Through me, your worthy servant, the master of all, the compassionate King of Kings. Grant also to him the
of the holy body and precious blood of your Christ. Keep him in the Orthodox faith, deliver him from the evil one from all his workings, and preserve his soul in purity and righteousness through the saving fear of you, that he may please you in every word and deed, and may be a child and heir of your heavenly kingdom. For you are our God, the God who shows mercy and saves us, and to you we send the glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
But that doesn't mean that the church doesn't always have mercy, forgiveness available. ready for you, because the Lord wants you to be saved, not to punish you, not to condemn you, but to bring you into his kingdom. So as you go through life, always remember that the tears of repentance are your second baptism. Every time you turn away from God through repentance, he receives you back into his arms. So as you come tomorrow to communion for the first time, bring your kingdom with you. It's a symbol of the life of Christ that you now have shown in your heart. Congratulations to your friends and family who joined you here. Enjoy the occasion.
David was a student.